I'll continue with the scale loft command, and this time I will use the two different type of sections on the two ends of the solid, and the one is circle, second is a square or the rectangle, and this can be of any section. Starting with the XY plane, and click on the look at, and from a sketching tab, choose circle and draw one circle of any diameter, but I will draw of the 1 meter as I am doing for all the examples up till now. And move it towards the circle and go back to modeling tab, and then from concept click on the lines from sketches and choose the sketch 1 here, which is here. This will create a one line from the this whole sketch. This is one circular line or circumference of circle, and generate. And I need to divide this circle into the four parts, as I will have the four parts for the rectangle as well or square as well, and they should be of corresponding side. So one should be from here to here, second from here to here. So start from 45 degrees and end at the 135 degrees, and then every sector will be of the 9 degrees. So four sectors. And to make it four sectors, I need to divide this geometry into the first 8 parts, and then join these two parts on the every corner, every side, and make them 4. So split by the end, which is the command here. There are multiple commands. One is fractional, where you can get the fraction of the value from 0 to 1. And this will divide this geometry at the in the percentage of the location. So 1%, 0%, 1%, 2%. This is going to be the 25% of 0.25. This is the 50% of 0.5. This is 0.75. Again, it's a 1. So I will use the split by n number of the values, and I will choose the number of division as a 8 and click on generate. So you can see that we have the 8 sections now, and then again go back to the tools command, and from here click on the merge, and merge these two edges or curves, and similarly these two edges, and make them the 4. Because the corresponding edges on the rectangle will be also 4. So just continue with this merge command. Generate. And the last one again for the merge command. And generate. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now I will go to this XY plane, and I will create a one plane at the Z location is equal to 5. So this will be length of the my geometry in the Z direction. So I will move this, I will copy this plane at the location of the 5 meters in the Z direction. So click on create new plane, and this will be the reference plane, will be the from XY plane, and transform in the Z direction by distance of the 5 meters. You can choose any distance, but I am continuing with my same geometry, same dimensions here. That's why I'm choosing the 5 meters. And click on the generate, and then choose the plane number 4 and click on the look at. And from a sketching tab, I will this time select the rectangle. There's no option for the square, but you can make the rectangle into square by having same dimensions on the all four sides. So start from the one quadrant, and then it should be going through all the quadrants here and end up anywhere in the last quadrant. And now I want to make this geometry symmetric around the x-axis and y-axis. So for that, I have the command in the constraints. And in the constraints, click on symmetry. First, choose the axis around which you want to make the geometry symmetrical. So let's say first the x-axis, and then choose the tool edges of the geometry. And similarly on the y-axis, choose these two edges. So undo y-axis and choose these two edges. And again, just make sure that we have symmetry around the x-axis also. Okay, so we are done. And now go to dimensions, and from here choose a general dimension. So choose dimension and choose any edge, and also on the vertical edge. And defining the one of these edges will define the length of the rectangle, and any dimension on the one side of these two sides will define the height of the rectangle. So let's say I make it 4. You can also make the rectangle, or you can make the square. So I have the two geometries. One is this circle here on the xy plane, and second one is my square on the plane, which is at the distance of the 5 meters from the xy plane. And now choose a skin load command, and this time don't select all profiles, but instead select the individual profiles, because we have the different profiles on the different sections. And select these profiles on the circular cylinder on the xy plane, and second profile, which will be on the second plane, which is a distance of 5 meters from the xy plane. And if you want, you can also add the extra profile. So there are multiple profiles, you can select them. So now we have the two profiles, and you can see we have some preview of geometry here, and click on generate. So this is geometry we are getting from the here. And if you move this plane 4 a distance, let's say 10 meters, so geometry will be slightly different here, and click on generate. And you can also change the dimension of the section to, let's say I make it as a 8 or 6, and click on generate. So in this way we can get the shape for the nozzle as well. So in this way you can also make the geometry of the nozzle with these commands, and or any type of geometry which has multiple sections. The one most prominent example is the wind turbine geometry. And one more thing, I have created these name selections. They will be used to define the boundary condition. So one is still there, so I can tell you that how you can define the name selection. So let's say I make this condition as a wall 4, and click on generate. So just select the surface, and then right click and click on name selection, put the name here, and then click on generate. And you can change the color also by the name selections. So from here click on the color by the name selection. So we can have the multiple colors as well for the geometry.